हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक इन टुडेज लेक्चर CHA 392 सेक्शन 2 लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी। आई एम मिस्टर वीडी जाधव, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री KTHM कॉलेज नासिक 2। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन एनालिटिकल HPLC। इन दैट peak height and peak area determination for quantitative analysis, integration errors, the detection wavelength, derivatization, unexpected peaks, ghost and system peaks we have seen. In today's lecture, we see supercritical fluid chromatography. Students, for today's session, learning objective is student should able to define, understand various terms in supercritical fluid chromatography. Also, explain instrumentation in supercritical fluid chromatography. Explain and describe basic principles of supercritical fluid chromatography. Separation in supercritical fluid chromatography column. Also, functioning and construction of supercritical fluid detectors. Also, students should able to explain and describe application of supercritical fluid chromatography in industry and in analytical laboratory. Introduction, you know chromatography. Chromatography is the separation techniques of complex chemical mixtures into individual components. Supercritical fluid chromatography can be used on an analytical scale. It is combination of high performance liquid chromatography, that is HPLC, and gas chromatography. It can be used with non-volatile and thermally labile analytes. It can be used with the universal flame ionization detector. It is important to producing narrower peaks due to rapid diffusion. It is important for the chiral separations and analysis of high molecular weight hydrocarbons. Supercritical fluids are suitable as a substitute for organic solvents in a range of industrial and laboratory processes. History of supercritical fluid chromatography. Use of supercritical fluid chromatography was first proposed in 1958 by J. Lovelock. First reported use was in 1962 by Lesper et al., who was separated thermally liable porphyrins. Definition of supercritical fluid chromatography. It is simply a combination of high performance liquid chromatography HPLC and gas chromatography GC. A supercritical fluid chromatography is a material that can be either liquid or gas used in state above critical temperature or critical pressure, where gases and liquid can coexist. Is known as supercritical fluid chromatography. Principle of supercritical fluid chromatography. It is combination of gas chromatography and HPLC. The principle is based on adsorption and partition chromatography. The principle based on triple point and critical point. The principle is based on supercritical fluid. Important terminology in this session, critical temperature. First one, critical temperature. The critical temperature of a substance is the temperature at and above which vapor of the substance cannot be liquefied, no matter how much pressure is applied. Critical pressure is nothing but the pressure, the critical pressure of a substance is the pressure required to liquefy a gas at its critical temperature. And supercritical fluid chromatography temperature is nothing but for every substance there is a temperature above which it cannot longer exist as a liquid no matter how much pressure is applied. Same critical pressure, supercritical fluid chromatography pressure is for every substance there is a pressure above which it cannot longer exist as a liquid no matter how high temperature is raised. Triple point, you know the triple point, the point in which state of material changes at a constant temperature and pressure. In this pressure temperature PT diagram clearly shows critical point, supercritical region, three state of matter, that is solid, liquid, gas, and triple point. In a supercritical fluid chromatography, solvent used, carbon dioxide and water are the most commonly used supercritical fluids being used for decaffeination and power generation respectively. Many pressurized gases are actually supercritical fluids. For example, nitrogen has a critical point of 126.2 Kelvin, that is minus 147 degrees Celsius, and 3.4 megapascal, that is 34 bar pressure. Therefore, nitrogen or compressed air in a gas cylinder above this pressure is actually a supercritical fluid. There are many often known as permanent gases. At room temperature, they are well above their critical temperature and therefore behave as a gas. Similar to CO2, at 400 Kelvin above, however, they cannot be liquefied by pressure unless cool below their critical temperature. In this table, the solvent or fluids in supercritical fluid chromatography, their critical temperature and critical pressure are shown. First, carbon dioxide, their critical temperature 30.41 degrees Celsius and critical pressure in bar 73.8. Same, ethane, ethylene, propane, propylene, trifluoromethane, chloroform, and chlorotrifluoromethane, their critical temperature and critical pressure are shown. Next, properties of supercritical fluid. There is a no surface tension in supercritical fluid, as there is a no liquid gas phase boundary. Solubility in a supercritical fluid tends to increase with density of the liquid at constant temperature. Since density increases with pressure, solubility tends to increase with pressure. At a constant density, solubility will increase with temperature. Choice of supercritical fluids solvents. Good solubilizing and penetrating property inner to the product, easy separation from the product, and cheap. The solvent should be cheap. Also, low cost price because of economic reasons. Advantages of supercritical fluids. Advantages of supercritical fluids over carrier gases and liquid mobile phases are in its solubility properties, physical properties, and detector compatibility. द सॉल्वेटिंग पावर ऑफ सुपरक्रिटिकल फ्लूड्स इज वेरी सिमिलर टू मेनी कन्वेंशनल ऑर्गेनिक सॉल्वेंट्स एंड मच हायर देन इन गैसेस. डिफ्यूजन कोएफिशिएंट एंड विस्कोसिटी ऑफ सुपरक्रिटिकल फ्लूड्स आर अबाउट 5 to 50 टाइम्स हायर देन इन लिक्विड्स. ऑल्सो हाई डेंसिटी ऑफ सुपरक्रिटिकल फ्लूड्स एबल टू डिजोल्व लार्ज नॉन होलाटाइल मॉलिक्यूल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल CO2 डिजोल्स एन अल्केन हैविंग एन 5 to 22 पॉलीसाइक्लिक एरोमेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. Therefore, CO2 is used for extraction of caffeine and nicotine. Analyte can be easily recovered by allowing the solution to equilibrate at relatively low temperature. Diffusivity of solute is higher. Viscosity is lower, so very useful for compounds which have no functional group as detection methods in HPLC fails. Next, phase diagram. These all are the advantages of CO2. Therefore, CO2 is used as a supercritical fluids. This is carbon dioxide density pressure phase diagram. Triple point of CO2. Critical point. This is also density pressure phase diagram of CO2. Instrumentation of supercritical fluid chromatography. The instrumentation of SFC includes mobile phase, stationary phase, pump, injection system, oven, column and detector. These are the block diagram of SFC chromatography. Mobile phase, there are a number of possible fluids which may be used in supercritical fluid chromatography as the mobile phase. Mostly CO2 is used. The main disadvantage of carbon dioxide is its inability to elute very polar or ionic compounds. This can be overcome by adding a small portion of second fluid called a modifier fluid. Such modifier fluids are alcohols, cyclic ethers, acetonitrile and chloroform. The addition of the modifier fluid improve the solvating ability of the supercritical fluid and sometimes enhances selectivity of the separation. Next, stationary phase. Same as those for gas chromatography and liquid chromatography, that is HPLC, with some modification, silica and alumina, useful for non-polar compounds, lead to irreversible adsorption of some polar solutes. Widely used polar stationary phases for supercritical fluid chromatography are polysilogenes. They are stable, flexible, silicon-oxygen bonds lead to good diffusion, substituted with chemical groups for selective interaction with analyte. Polymethyl siloxanes, they increase efficiency in separating closely related polar analytes. Cyanopropyl polysiloxanes, they are useful for compounds with COOH group, that is acid group. Other supercritical fluid chromatography solvents are nitrous oxide, similar in solvating and separation properties to CO2, but it is expensive. Alkanes, less safe and not as a detector compatible than CO2. Better solvent characteristic in nonpolar solute. In that case, alkanes are used. Hydrocarbons, xenon, etc. Xenon, specialty applications only, especially applications only, more polar solvents for highly polar and high molecular weight compounds. Next, instrumentation part for supercritical fluid chromatography is pumps. Flow controlling is the vital function of pumping systems. In contrast to HPLC, pumping systems, pressure rather than flow control is necessary and pulseless operation is more important. In general, type of high pressure pump used in supercritical fluid is determined by column type. For packed columns, for easier blending of mobile phase or introduction of modifier fluids, reciprocating pumps are generally used. For capillary supercritical fluid syringe pumps are most commonly employed. Reciprocating pumps allow easier mixing of mobile phase or introduction of modifier fluids. Syringe pumps provide consistent pressure for net mobile phase. Next part of instrumentation is oven. A thermostated column oven is required for precise temperature control of the mobile phase. Conventional gas chromatography or HPLC liquid chromatography ovens are generally used. Next, back pressure device or restrictor. This is a device which is used to maintain desired pressure in column by pressure adjustable diaphragm or control nozzle so that same column outlet pressure is maintained irrespective of mobile phase pump flow rate. It keeps mobile phase supercritical throughout separation and often must be heated to prevent clogging. Pressure restriction is placed either at the end of the column or after detector. Next, instrumentation part is injectors. Injector for packed supercritical fluid chromatography, a conventional HPLC injection system is adequate, but for a capillary column supercritical fluid chromatography, a small volume depends on column diameters and small volume must be quickly injected into column. Therefore, pneumatically driven values are used. Loop injectors, it is a direct transposition of what is applied in analytical supercritical fluid chromatography, used mostly for preliminary test of column, performance and elution parameters. Inline injection, more versatile system, offers better flexibility for changing injected volume. High pressure pump required to inject feed solution. Injected stream dissolve in diluent flow. Next, in column injection and alternative systems permit injection of feed solution directly into column. No dilutions required. These are the loop injector. These are the loop injectors. Here, in column injectors, inline injectors. This is guard column, analytical column, inline filter and injector. Column, once the samples is injected into supercritical stream, it is carried into the analytical column that contains a highly viscous liquid, that is stationary phase, into which the analyte can be temporarily adsorbed and then released based on their chemical nature. This temporary retention causes some analytes to remain longer in the column and is what allows the separation of the mixture. Different types of stationary phases are available with varying composition and polarities. There are two types of analytical columns used in supercritical fluid chromatography. First one, packed column, contains small deactivated particles, so which the stationary phases adheres the columns are conventionally stainless steel. Next type, capillary columns, are open tubular columns of narrow internal diameter made of fused silica silex with the stationary phase bonded to the wall of the column. These are the commonly used column in the SFC, that is supercritical fluid chromatography. Next, detector. Most any detector used in gas chromatography or HPLC can be used. FID and UV detector, flame ionization detector and UV detectors commonly used. Coupled detector such as mass spectrometry and FTIR are also used. Supercritical SFC instrumentation in laboratory. This figure here comparison of HPLC and SFC peaks, comparison of chromatograms obtained by conventional partition chromatography HPLC and supercritical fluid chromatography SFC. This is retention times of peak HPLC and retention time in minute of peak in SFC. In supercritical fluid chromatography, the mobile phase is initially pumped as a liquid and is brought into the supercritical region by heating it above its supercritical temperature before it enters the analytical column. It passes through an injection wall where the sample is introduced into the supercritical stream and then into the analytical column. It is maintained supercritical as it passes through the column and into the detector by a pressure restrictor placed either after the detector or at the end of the column. The restrictor is a vital component as it keeps the mobile phase supercritical throughout the separation and often must be heated to prevent clogging. Both variables and fixed restrictors are available. Supercritical fluid chromatography advantages. SFC has several main advantages over other conventional chromatographic techniques such as GC and HPLC. Compared with HPLC, SFC provides rapid separation without the use of organic solvents, with the desire for environmentally conscious technology. The use of organic chemicals as used in HPLC could be reduced with the use of SFC, because SFC generally uses carbon dioxide collected as a byproduct of the chemical reaction or is collected directly from the atmosphere. It contributes no new chemicals to the environment. In addition, SFC separations can be done faster than HPLC separation because the diffusion of solutes in supercritical fluid is about 10 times greater than that in liquid and about 3 times less than in gaseous. This results in a decrease in resistance to mass transfer in the column and allows for fast high resolution separations. Compared with GC, capillary SFC cannot provide high resolution chromatography at much lower temperature. This allows fast analysis of thermolabile compounds. Finally, SFC have the advantage of higher diffusion constant and lower viscosities relative to liquid solvents. The low viscosity means that pressure drop across the column for a given flow rate is greatly reduced. The greater diffusibility means longer column length can be used. Higher diffusion coefficient means higher analysis speed that increases in the order HPLC, SFC and GC. These advantages are important in both chromatography and extraction with supercritical fluid chromatographies, SFCs. Applications: SFC finds use in industry primarily for separation of chiral molecules and uses the same column as a standard HPLC systems. SFC is now commonly used for a chiral separations and purification in the pharmaceutical industry. Fossil fuel and hydrocarbon, polymers, drugs and pharmaceuticals, explosive and propellants, lipids, carbohydrates, industrial chemicals, foods and flavors. Natural products, metal chelates and organoleptics compounds, enantiomers, etc. Assignment for this session: what is supercritical fluid chromatography? Explain principle and instrumentation of supercritical fluid chromatography. What is mean by supercritical fluid? What properties of supercritical fluid that are important in chromatography? Which detector cannot be used in supercritical fluid chromatography? What is an example of a supercritical fluid? Which mobile phases is used in SFC? Summary for this session: we first see introduction, then history, definition of SFC, principle, important terminology in SFC, SFC solvent, property of supercritical fluid, choice of supercritical fluid solvents, advantages of supercritical fluids, then phase diagram of CO2, carbon dioxide density pressure phase diagram, instrumentation of supercritical fluid chromatography, working of SFC, then SFC advantages, and last applications. Supercritical fluid extraction, advantages of supercritical fluid extraction, instrumentation of line and online extraction, and application of supercritical fluid extraction are learned.